fights in the shadow. In their blood, the Maker's will is written.
See reason, Lysette. We cannot stay here.
Why not?
Because we're Templar.
Yes.
I'd like your take on the Templar Order.
It's a shadow of what it was. Where once we both protected all people from the dangers of magic, we now posture and grab at power. One day, I hope the circles are again sanctuaries where mages can practice their craft.
You're not going to rejoin the Order?
When the temple went up, your forces rescued those few of us still alive. My life is a debt I intend to repay, however I can.
Do you have any idea what caused the explosion?
No, I'm just a recruit. Belief and faith doesn't get you closer to the important meetings. Though that distance did save my life.
I will talk to you later.
Walk in the Maker's grace.
Might be something here. Better take a closer look. Thank you.
O Creator, see me kneel. My walk on the way.
Come on, you've seen our mounts. Most of them should be pulling plows.
We didn't all grow up with fancy noble horses on the boat. You ride whatever holds you. Why are you here with the scouts instead of fobbing around with the nobles anyway?
My uncle died at the conclave. I'm a good rider, and, well, I thought I'd be more useful here.
Another time, then. You need something, let me know.
Still got demons pouring out of the rifts.
How could that great breach not have been caused by the mages?
It is reasonable to believe that magic was involved, but we cannot assume it was the rebel.
O Creator, see me kneel. For I walk only where you would bid me. Stand on.
Ally with the Templars, I'd imagine. I've seen them. We
sing play. Only the words you rebel place mages. In my throat.
Rebel mages probably made that damn breach.
Too many wounded. Not enough bandages to go around.
Does it trouble you?
I just wish I knew what it was, or how I got it.
We will find out. What's important is that your mark is now stable, as is the breach. You've given us time, and Solas believes a second attempt might succeed, provided the mark has more power. The same level of power used to open the breach in the first place. That is not easy to come by.
Couldn't that kind of power just make things worse?
And people call me a pessimist. May I present Commander Cullen, leader of the Inquisition's forces.
Such as they are, we lost many soldiers in the valley, and I fear many more before this is through.
This is Lady Josephine Montelier, our ambassador and chief diplomat.
Anderan Atishan.
You speak Elven?
You just heard the entirety of it, I'm afraid.
And of course you know Sister Leliana.
My position here involves a degree of...
She is our spymaster.
Yes. Tactfully put, Cassandra.
That's an impressive bunch of titles.
I mentioned that your mark needs more power to close the breach for good.
Which means we must approach the rebel mages for help.
And I still disagree. The Templars could serve just as well.
We need power, Commander. Enough magic poured into that mark.
Might destroy us all. Templars could suppress the breach, weaken it, so...
Pure speculation.
I was a Templar. I know what they're capable of.
Unfortunately, neither group will even speak to us yet. The Chantry has denounced the Inquisition, and you specifically.
They still think I'm guilty.
That is not the entirety of it any longer. Some are calling you, a Dalish elf, the Herald of Andraste. That frightens the Chantry. The remaining clerics have declared it blasphemy, and we, heretics, for harboring you.
Chancellor Roderick's doing, no doubt.
It limits our options. Approaching the mages or Templars for help is currently out of the question.
Just how am I the Herald of Andraste?
People saw what you did at the temple, how you stopped the breach from growing. They have also heard about the woman seen in the rift when we first found you. They believe that was Andraste.
Even if we tried to stop that view from spreading...
Which we have not.
The point is, everyone is talking about you.
It's quite the title, isn't it? How do you feel about that?
It's... a little unsettling.
I'm sure the Chantry would agree.
People are desperate for a sign of hope. For some, you're that sign.
And to others, a symbol of everything that's gone wrong. So if I wasn't with the Inquisition...
Well, let's be honest, they would have censured us no matter what.
And you not being here isn't an option.
There is something you can do. A Chantry cleric by the name of Mother Giselle has asked to speak to you. She is not far, and knows those involved far better than I. Her assistance could be invaluable.
She's asked for me. You don't think that could be an ambush?
I doubt it. From what I know of her, she's a kind soul, and not the sort to involve herself in violence. You will find Mother Giselle tending to the wounded in the hinterlands near Redcliffe.
Look for other opportunities to expand the Inquisition's influence while you're there.
We need agents to extend our reach beyond this valley, and you're better suited than anyone to recruit them.
In the meantime, let's think of other options. I won't leave this all to the Herald.
Have you had any trouble with them?
Not at all. I will inform...
Herald of Andraste. I've heard the stories. Everyone has. We know what you did at the breach. It's odd for a Dalish elf to care what happens to anyone else, but you'll get no backtalk here. That's a promise. Inquisition Scout Harding, at your service. I, well, all of us here, will do whatever we can to help.
Harding, huh? Ever been to Kirkwall's Hightown?
I can't say I have. Why?
You'd be Harding and... No, never mind.
Ugh.
I'm starting to worry about these stories that everyone's heard.
Oh, there's nothing to worry about. They only say you're the last great hope for Thedas.
Oh, wonderful.
The Hinterlands are as good a place as any to start fixing things. We came to secure horses from Redcliffe's old horsemaster. I grew up here, and people always said that Dennett's herds were the strongest and the fastest this side of the Frostbacks. But with the Mage Templar fighting getting worse, we couldn't get to Dennett. Maker only knows if he's even still alive. Mother Giselle's at the crossroads helping refugees and the wounded. Our latest reports say that the war's spread there too. Corporal Vale and our men are doing what they can to help protect the people, but they won't be able to hold out very long. You best get going. No time to lose.
This might interest you, sir.
What is it?
Could prove useful, sir. Apostates!
I'm not familiar with this.
The apostates have fled to the hills.
Think twice before attacking the Inquisition now.
What's that?
Where does this...
mages and Templars and innocent people caught in the middle. Some things never change. Interesting reading. Could be worth a look.
That tower is impressive, even as a ruin. I wonder what dreams it might hold. It must have been some time since the renegade Templars faced a mage of any talent.
I hear reconstruction is progressing well in Kirkwall.
I know things are bad there.
I wasn't trying to...
You weren't trying to remind me how bad it is in Kirkwall, so you decided to talk about it?
About its recovery.
That will take years. People don't recover so easily. With the skull.
Look, that's the King's Road down there. Inquisition forces. They're trying to protect the refugees.
Looks like they could use a hand.
Hold. We are not apostates.
I do not think they care, Seeker. We are not Templars. We mean you no harm.
Doesn't look like they're listening.
Be ready. More coming our way.
are victorious once more.
There are mages here who can heal your wounds. Lie still.
Don't touch me, Mother. Their magic is...
Turn to noble purpose. Their magic is surely no more evil than your blade.
What?
Hush, dear boy. Allow them to ease your suffering.
Mother Giselle.
I am. And you must be the one they are calling the Herald of Andraste.
What you said to that soldier...
We do not teach that magic is evil. We teach that pride is evil, and does not corrupt only mages. But I did not ask you to come simply to debate with me.
Then why am I here?
I know of the Chantry's denouncement, and I am familiar with those behind it. I won't lie to you. Some of them are grandstanding, hoping to increase their chances of becoming the new divine. Some are simply terrified. So many good people, senselessly taken from us.
What happened was horrible.
Fear makes us desperate, but hopefully not beyond reason. Go to them. Convince the remaining clerics you are no demon to be feared. They have heard only frightful tales of you. Give them something else to believe.
That won't just make it worse.
Because you are a mage?
That too.
Let me put it this way. You needn't convince them all. You just need some of them to doubt. The power is the unified voice. Take that from them and you receive the time you need.
You make it sound simple.
I honestly don't know if you've been touched by fate, or sent to help us, but I hope. Hope is what we need now. The people will listen to your rallying call, as they will listen to no other. You could build the Inquisition into a force that will deliver us, or destroy us. I will go to Haven, and provide Sister Leliana the names of those in the Chantry who will be amenable to a gathering. It is not much, but I will do whatever I can.
Corporal Vale is coordinating the Inquisition's efforts in the area. We should speak with him.
Good to have commerce restored. I've many goods here if you wish to trade.
To hear it.
Please, somebody, my wife needs help.
What's wrong with your wife?
She gets sick when the weather's foul. Can't catch her breath, like cobwebs in her lungs. Our son Hindle makes a potion that lets her breathe. He's the only one who can make it, but he's joined that cult in the hills. Please, get to him and tell him what's wrong. Without that potion, she'll die.
That's the last of the bread. Going to be a long, hungry night.
These people need food.
There are rams out in the hills. Good eating, cooks easy, and no lords around to kill you for poaching. Too dangerous to go hunting now. More likely to find mages than luck.
Good luck.
Luck.
You're with the Inquisition. Corporal Vale, thanks for your help. The Mages and Templars don't seem to care who gets caught in their war. The refugees here are in dire need of help. If the war doesn't kill them, cold or starvation will.
What can you tell me about the Templars?
All the Templars were called to Val Royeau not long ago. These bastards ignored the order. Now they're killing rebel mages, along with any refugees they think are mage sympathizers. Every Templar I've ever known has wanted to protect the common folk. These men defile their order's good name.
What can you tell me about the rebel mages?
The real rebels are up north in Redcliffe, dug in and taking care of their own. The ones out here are just a... The rebels in Redcliffe have washed their hands of them. I wish we could do the same.
You were concerned about...
Yes. Many of them brought food. There's a hunter up the hill who had some ideas.
What other problems do these refugees face?
We've got some injuries that go beyond stitches and elf fruit. I know healers are in short supply, but if you can find someone in Redcliffe to help us, it would save a lot of lives.
Is there anything we can do to help people deal with the cold?
I asked the Inquisition to send blankets. You'd think I was asking for a wagon of raw lyrium. A recruit named Whittle is trying to make what we can bring in last. If you have any ideas, talk to him across the road.
What can you tell me about the man who's supposed to be getting horses for the Inquisition?
Horsemaster Dennett. He lives on a farm to the west. Tough old fella. We haven't heard from him. Best we can tell, he's holed up until the Mages and Templars are done killing each other.
Farewell.
And you as well.
Just what I have.
No, they don't.
It's just
more cold
heard.
Weather coming. Fool villagers. Where are their coats?
What do you need to keep these refugees warm?
Blankets, warm clothes, all of it. These poor sods lost everything when the mages and the Templars went crazy. If we were in a village, I could just pinch a blanket off a clothesline and be fine. Out here, I'm sure the apostates have plenty of supplies, just haven't been able to find them.
Farewell.
And see you.
Look at this. The apostates have gone mad with power.
I see just as many Templars. We can only restore order by securing an alliance.
That's what the skull helped you find? Right. Not ominous at all.
Thank you.
Perhaps the Inquisition could determine the nature of these objects.
So if we get better horses, you think that'll make a difference?